Hi everyone, this is Pratyush, founder of Proxlight, and welcome to a new tutorial. In this tutorial, we will be creating a virtual desktop assistant using Python. So if you want to run your machine on your command like Jarvis did for Tony, then we will be using this particular program to run our machine. So basically, we will be using some of the basic modules of the Python to create this particular application. Python offers a variety of library which you can use with, but we will be using basic 4 library to create this program. So let's get started with the program. So here I'm inside my command prompt, and the first library we will be using is PyTTSX3, which is a platform independent text to speech conversion library, and the major advantage is it works most often offline. So you can use this particular library offline. Now what we will be doing is we will be trying to convert our text into speech. So for that we need to install this first. So just pip install it on your system. So I will just type pip install and then name of your module. So you can use this command to install PyTTSX3 on your system. Now the second thing we will be using is speech recognition. So speech recognition will let you recognize the speech given by the user so that we can convert it into text and then modify it as per our need. Or basically we will be processing it in our need. So to install it, just type pip install and type in your command, for example, speech recognition. So after installing it, the next library we will be using is web browser. Now web browser generally comes pre-installed with Python, so you don't have to install it by external pip. So it is just installed on your system. So we will be skipping this part because web browser is very simple module. It will let you to optimize your browser experience, or I would say you can search, like you can have a Google search with the help of that web browser. It's quite simple with that. So the next module we will be using is Wikipedia. So it will help us in fetching the information directly from the Wikipedia website so that we can show the user about the information that they want. So to install Wikipedia, just type in pip install and then Wikipedia, somewhere like this, and then hit enter on your keyboard to install this library even though. So after installing all of them, let's have a look at the program which we will be building today. So let's have a look at the demo finally. So here is the demo, and as you can see, first of all, it will greet you somewhere like this.
Hello sir, I am your desktop assistant. Tell me, how may I help you?
So after greeting you, it will just recognize your audio. So for example, I have just given a command like the which day it is. Basically, this is a very basic command. So now it will try to recognize it. Then it will print the command as over here, as you can see, which day it is. So it is printing the which day it is. Basically, this is the command that we have given. Now it will try to answer it. For example, this is Wednesday, then it is printing Wednesday, as you can see. Now it will try to listen again as you have ended up your command. So this is the very basic or kind of very simple assistant we will be creating. Now if I ask him to open browser and run Proxlight, then it will run our website directly over there. So it's quite simple. You can add commands and delete them as per your wish. So as you can modify it. So it's quite simple and quite easy to use. So with that being said, let's start coding. So here I'm inside my Visual Studio Code. Now I will be first of all importing all the required libraries. So the first one is PyTTSX3. So just import PyTTSX3. Now the second one is speech recognition. I will be importing it as SR. As you can see over here, I have imported it as SR. Now it will be easy for us to just repeat that particular sentence again and again. Alright, so the third thing we need is web browser. So I will be just importing web browser like this. So it's quite easy. So the next step, we will be importing date and time. So we want our assistant to tell us date and time. The next required module is Wikipedia. So just type in import Wikipedia. So first of all, we want our assistant to take commands. So here I have created a chunk of code. So as you can see, I have defined a command over here that it should be take command. And then first of all, it should recognize. We will be using a recognizer function from the sound recognizer. Now we will be using microphone as the basic source, and then while listening, it will just print listening. Now the second thing is we will be changing the pause threshold to 0.7 and audio to listen, so that it should be basically listen the audio from the source. That is simple. Now we will be using some trial and error method over here, that if the voice is recognized, then it will just print that recognizing your audio. Now if it is not recognized, then it will throw an error like say that again sir or none. So basically this will return a none value over here, as you can see. Now we will be finally entering the query, so we will be returning the query. So the next thing is we will be speaking. So we want our virtual assistant to speak. So we have over here that we will be basically, I will be defining a speak over here. Inside I will be giving that audio. Now we will be using engine, in which we will be using pytsx3.init. So I have created an engine variable over here and I have stored that value. Now I will be trying to fetch some voices. Now you can have a look at their documentary over there, so that they have given a proper note on the voices they have given in their particular module. So we will be using some basic voices like Mark. You have over here like voices, and you can get the property of the voices. So you can select the voices basically and modify it as per your wish. So I will be changing the ID to like 0. So this 0 over here, as you can see, is a setter method. So 0 stands for male and 1 stands for female. So you can change the voices according to your need. So you can enter any ID over here from directly from their website. So it's quite simple over here. Now we will be using this method, same method, for making our assistant speak. So basically, to block all the current command, what we can do is we will be using run and wait method over here. So it will basically blocks all the incoming command currently. So the next chunk of code is the tell date method. So we will be creating or defining a function that can tell us the date. So basically, as you have seen in the demo, I have just asked the assistant for the date and it has returned me with the values. So basically this line is telling the day of the week. So basically you can ask any day from the week and it will tell you the day. So this line of code will tell us about the number, which will help us in retrieving the day from the week. And it is quite simple. Now if the number is in between the range 1 to 7, then it will return the value and it will speak the day is and the day. So it's quite simple over here. So we have used an if and we have easily printed that out using the day of the week, as we have created a variable on the above code. So it is quite simple. Now we will be doing the same for the time even though. So here is the chunk for the time. So this line of code basically retrieves the current time and it will just give the current time to the user. So on printing, it will print the time somewhat like in this format. And after slicing, we can get a uniform time in minute, second and hour. So it's quite simple. For example, over here, we have used the hour and in here we have minutes. So we are basically slicing each chunk of code into simpler one. And we are trying to retrieve that minute and hour from that particular dictionary that has been created by the time variable over there. Now this line of code will basically help us in speaking that particular time to the user. Now the next step is to create a hello method over here. So I will be creating a hello method. As you can see here, I have defined a hello method over here. So basically it will greet the user with like, hello sir, I'm your desktop assistant and tell me how can I help you. So basically this line of code will help them in speaking that particular thing. So it will greet the user and then start recognizing the audio. Now we will be using take query method, which will help us in taking queries from the user. I think calling the hello method will make it more interactive. So we can call here the hello method over here, as you can see. So this loop is infinite. So it will be taking our queries continuously until and unless we will be ending up with a command like bye to terminate the program. So we are taking the query over here and we are lowering it because most of the time it should be uniform to lower all the words or alphabets. So basically it will help us to get a perfect result as an output. So in this line of code, we will be opening our browser. So it will be our default browser. So if I say like open Google, then it will open up Google in our default browser. So as you can see over here, like if we open Proxlight, then it will open up Proxlight on proxlight.github.io on our default browser. Now we have different query over here, like which day it is, then it will be using the tell day method to return the day and tell the time. Similar goes for the time even though. We can use the by command over here to end up the conversation with the assistant. And same thing goes for the Wikipedia. So basically from Wikipedia, if you want to search something, then it will basically return and retrieve the data from the Wikipedia and then speak the result directly. So if I ask him that tell me your name, then it will return like I am Jarvis, your desktop assistant, which is quite simple. So now at the end, we will be using the main method for executing all the functions. So this was it guys, how to create a virtual desktop assistant using Python. So it was quite simple and I hope this tutorial was really helpful for you. And if it was helpful, then consider subscribing, hit that like button below. I will meet you in another tutorial. Until then, keep coding.